Welcome to another video. My name is Femi, and in this video you're going to discover how to prepare raw food for your puppy. So it is important to understand that when a puppy is born, they're naturally on their mother's milk up to at least 4 weeks. That's when they get introduced to solid food, and when I mean solid, it's going to be minced, mashed food. So in the case of Coco, at 3 weeks old, the breeder started giving her rice pudding and goat's milk. So that kind of introduced her to supplements. So she was having her mother's milk as well as having rice and pudding with goat's milk. Then at 4 weeks, the breeder then introduced her to minced beef. That beef would kind of give her that raw, that taste of a raw diet. And then from that 4 weeks to 8 weeks, the breeder introduced her to chicken, organ meats, to make sure that she has all the nutrient requirements for her to grow healthy. And at the time, the breeder also introduced 20% kibble to her diet. But when Coco arrived to my place, I decided to just switch her 100% on a raw diet. So when you have a puppy, a young puppy, they need every nutrient they can get on a daily basis. So you need to make sure that you're feeding them at least 3 to 4 times per day. In the case of Coco, she has a first meal at 7 a.m., a second meal at 12 noon, a third meal at 5 p.m., and then her last meal at 7 in the evening. Sorry, at 9 in the evening. So when you're looking to feed your puppy a raw diet, it is important to understand the basic rule, which is the 80-10-10 rule. So whatever diets that you're giving her or him, your puppy, it needs to be 80% meat, raw meat, without fat, without bone, and then 10% bone, and then 5% liver and 5% kidney. That is the foundation. That is not a balanced diet. You also need to give them fish, like salmon, mackerel, or sardine. That's what I give Coco. So for you to be able to give your puppy a raw diet, you first need to understand what they weigh. So you need to weigh your dog to see, okay, Coco came to us at like 6 kilograms, and we knew that, okay, 6 kilograms when she arrived, five and a half, 6 kilograms when she arrived. And she, from 2 months to 4 months, she was getting 8 to 10% of her body weight. So when I prepare her meal, I weigh her, and then I calculate 8% of her body weight. From that 8%, then 80% of that calculation needs to be raw meat. And when I say raw meat, it could be chicken, it could be beef, it could be pork, it could be lamb, it could be turkey, just meat without bone. And then 10% of that calculation needs to be bone. So Coco, I gave her chicken feet because she was a puppy. She couldn't eat stronger bones. But if you have a smaller dog, then you can kind of grind the bone. When you go to the butcher or wherever you get your meat from, you can ask them to put it in a grinder, and that will grind it up. So they're still essentially getting that nutrient, that bone. And then 5% liver, and then 5% kidney. You also need to introduce vegetables. So with Coco, I give her carrots, bananas, apples. So I give her a lot of fruits to kind of balance up the diet. It is also important to know that, okay, once you're feeding your dog, you also need to pay attention to their poo. So if it gets too watery, then you know they're getting a lot of meat and not enough bone. If it's too hard, then you know that you're giving them too much bone and not enough meat. So you can gauge what you give them based on their stool. And then the fact that you're feeding a raw diet doesn't necessarily mean you shouldn't give them anything else. Personally, I wouldn't feed my dog kibble. That's just my decision. It's not a knock on people that feed kibble, but personally, I wouldn't, just because I see it as junk, like junk food in the human context. But sometimes when Coco has maybe running poo or stuff like that, I switch her to cooked food. So there's nothing wrong with that. So you can cook chicken and make sure you cook it properly, and then remove the bones, remove all the bones, and then give it to her or to him. If you give them that, that probably will settle the if they're having runny poo, that will settle it. So when you're feeding your puppy a raw diet, you should not expect a perfect smooth experience. There will be situations where they wouldn't want to eat. Some of them will like one meat, they wouldn't like the other. So you just need to balance it. So I quickly realized that Coco doesn't like beef tongue. There's certain meats she doesn't like. But again, you need to be the one in control, because if you have a puppy that decides what they want to eat, then you have a problem. Then they will be very, very picky. So sometimes when I wake up in the morning, I try to give her a 7 o'clock meal. If she decides not to eat it, I'll take it away. And then I'll reintroduce that same meal at 12 in the afternoon. So when you're trying to feed your puppy a raw diet, it's gonna be a hit and miss, but you just want to make sure that they're getting 5% organ meat, 5% of their body weight, the liver, the bone, as well as the meat. So my name is Femi Olajiga. If you're new to the channel, consider subscribing and hitting on the bell notification. I'm going to be publishing more videos about dog training, dog diets, and every good stuff about dogs and having a perfect dog. Thank you.